We're all used to going to the clinic or going to outpatients and going to phlebotomy, and somebody sticks a needle in your arm and you have to give a little blood sample. And maybe, depending on what's wrong with you, they might give you a little kind of universal pot and ask you to wee into it. But we haven't traditionally been used to being given a little pot and asked to put a bit of poo in it. And for some people, that's a real sort of mental block. And somehow we've got to work out good, accessible ways of crossing that boundary.
How far away are we, if we are ever able to do it at all, to looking inside someone's guts, analysing it, and seeing which diseases they're predisposed to, and if we can prevent them or cure them?
Well, I think the progress is kind of incremental, isn't it? So your question is quite a tough call, isn't it? Because that suggests that for all these unknowns, we've got all these diseases where we imagine that it might matter, we'd have tied up those correlates and worked it out. So yes, one day, but some decades away. But there's a lot of steps before you get to that, aren't there? So could we get to the day where I can send off a sample of my poop to a company on the internet, you know, like I would, you know, a blood test to the NHS, and get back some kind of informative answer about, you know, the quality of my diet or my risk factors for disease? You could do that tomorrow if you, you know, you could set up a company like that tomorrow if you wanted to. So that would be a step, and then a step after that would be, well, based on that, you could say, what's wrong with my microbiome, and should I be eating something different or taking some dietary supplements or something like that? So that's not a very big step away from that. So you can see how it sort of build up incrementally, so that in the end it would be quite informative for disease risk and disease prevention. And I think that's why so many research funding boards, disease charity funders and things are interested in this area, because they can see how it translates. They can see that rather than just asking academic questions about mechanisms in arthritis or type 1 diabetes or multiple sclerosis, this could really lead to something where you could modulate diet or modulate food supplements or something and have some kind of impact. So I think that's what gets people excited.